virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshada Kale and today we will learn maths. Okay, now we will move to the chapter. Good morning children. Welcome to virtual class. I hope you are doing well. I am Akshata Kale and today we are going to learn the first topic of maths, that is introduction to geometrical figures. Students, you already have the knowledge about the geometrical figures because you studied about that in standard second. First, we will take the revision of what we have learned last year and then we will move to the next portion. Yes, dear students, observe these figures carefully. Yes, you can see here five figures. Now, please see that any similarity you can find in these figures. Yes, now we will count the sides. This is the first, second, third, and fourth. Right? Four sides this figure has. Now we will count the sides of one more figure, that is 1, 2, 3, and 4. I think you came to know the similarity, correct? That is, four sided closed figures are called as quadrilaterals. These figures have different shapes, but all have four sides and all are closed figures. So these type of figures, we call them as quadrilaterals. Yes, students, we see so many objects with this shape in our day-to-day life. See this window, chessboard, door, blackboard, mobile phone, currency note of rupees 100, tabletop, kite, and the monitor of the computer. Yes, so many objects we see in our surroundings and in our house of this shape. Right? Now we move to the next shape. Observe this carefully. Again, we can see different figures and one similarity is there among them. Yeah, again we will count the sides or edges. This one has 1, 2, and 3 sides. One more figure we will take. Okay, last one. 1, 2, and 3. This also has 3 sides. So again, this is a closed figure. Guess the name of this. You are right. That is nothing but triangle. Here we can write the statement like this. Three-sided closed figures are called as triangles. Now we will move to the objects of this shape. See students here. Yes, piece of a pizza, signal board. This is a piece of a watermelon. And the upper portion of the house. Can you see there? These all show a triangular shape. Many more objects are there with this shape in our surroundings. Okay? Now, the another shape, see this. This you know, this is a round, or you call as a circle. Here we can see three different sized circles. Here we can write the statement like this: a round shaped figure with no sides. Remember, circle has no sides, correct? No edges, no corners, nothing. The objects with circular shape, we can see a wall clock, a tire, round biscuit, CD drive, bangles, and many more objects we can see in our home and also in our surroundings with this circular shape. Now students, here one table is there. You have to complete this. Now you have to identify the geometrical figure, draw it and write its name. This is in your textbook on page number 1st. Okay, this you have to complete with the help of the pencil in your textbook. And one more picture is there below that. Here, what is asked? Let me read. Identify the triangles, circles, and quadrilaterals in the picture above. You are familiar with these three types of figures, correct? Now, color the triangles in red. Wherever the triangle is there, you have to color it in red. The quadrilaterals in blue and the circles in yellow. Students, I will do one for you. See, this is a triangle, so I put red color in this. This is the quadrilateral. They asked us to fill with the blue color. And your circle with yellow color. Okay, there are so many quadrilaterals, triangles and circles. You have to use the color pencils and color it. Then you will get a beautiful colorful picture. Okay, we will move further. Now, we will study something more about the quadrilateral. Now, see students, here this is a quadrilateral because it has four sides and a closed figure. Now, students, we will count the edges and corners of this quadrilateral. See, this is called edge. Okay, now this is the first edge, second, third and the fourth. Means you can write here the quadrilateral has four edges. Now we will count the corners. See, this is the corner. You know about the corner, the meaning of the corner, that is the joint. Okay, this is first one, here second, third, fourth. See, here we can write it has four corners. Now the statement we can write like this: the quadrilateral has four edges and four corners, and this is fixed. The next thing is triangle. Again, this is a triangle. Now we will see the edges first. Here it has 1, 2 and 3. Means you can write here 3 edges. And how many corners? Let me count. 1, 2, 3. Now it has three corners. Means we can write like this. The triangle has three edges and three corners. Sorry, three corners. The next figure is circle. Please observe carefully. We are going to count the edges and corners of the circle. Now, can you find any edges or corners? No. So here, the circle has no edges and no corners. Remember this. Okay. Now the next thing is we will learn about rectangle and its sides. See students, this is a rectangle. It has four sides and four corners. This is a quadrilateral. Correct? Now students, we will study about its lengths and its breadth. Okay, means lengthier side and shorter side. Now we will fold this paper in the middle and let us watch what will happen. Now I'm going to fold this paper in the middle. See dear students, what happened here? The longer sides falls exactly on the opposite sides and the shorter sides also falls exactly on the opposite sides. Means what we can write here? The opposite sides of a rectangle are of equal length. Remember this. The next thing is square. We will take a square paper. Your handkerchief is always in square shape. Okay, again we will also, we here also we will fold the paper like this. The down corner we will fold on the upper one. Yeah, I will draw a line. See this. You observe this. Now I will take this a little far and I will put this on the another side. Can you see here? Did you observe anything? Yes. Here all the edges of square match in length. Means all four sides of a square are equal in length. If one side is 5 cm, then all the rest sides are also 5 cm. This is the special property of a square. Yes, students, here you can see a table. Complete the table below. This is in your textbook on page number 3. Okay. Now here you have to write name of the figure, then you have to count the number of edges and number of corners. I will do one for you. This is the quadrilateral and the edges it has 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, it has 4 edges and 4 corners. The second figure, I will write the name rectangle, number of edges 4 and number of corners 4. Yes, rest 3 figures you have to name, you have to write the edges, you have to write the number of corners. Okay, this is on page number 3. Yes, students, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, students, for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get new updated videos.